In my family, my mama was one of six girls and one boy. And that meant that I had six aunts and six uncles. And then my mama was the baby of the family. So there were 16 of us first cousins in my mama's family. And a lot of them were already grown up and had families of their own and kids. And we would have, we called them the annual family picnic. It was like, you know, a reunion. Now, at our family picnics, every family was expected to bring something. But not just something. There was like four items that each family was suggested to bring, see. You had your meats, you know, and my Aunt Asley made one of the best meatloafs in the world, so she would always bring a meatloaf. And then my Aunt Gretchen made a really good barbecue. She'd bring barbecue. My mama was like the fried chicken queen of the Southeast. She would bring fried chicken. See, everybody would bring a meat, and then you would bring like a vegetable. And a vegetable would be like a pot of green beans or maybe some mashed potatoes or something. Casserole, broccoli casserole counted as a vegetable. And even though neither one of them are a vegetable separately, when you combine macaroni and cheese, it becomes a vegetable, see? So that was all right. But now sliced tomatoes, that don't count as a vegetable. Sliced tomatoes is in the next food group, which is called your side dish, see? Now in that food group would be like your sliced tomatoes, your sliced cantaloupe, maybe your bread and butter pickles, your deviled eggs came in there, see? That's a side dish. And then you were also required to bring, of course, a dessert. Now in my family, the word cannoli never came up much. Scone, didn't think of that. In my family, chocolate chip cookies weren't even considered dessert. It had to be cake or pie, right? And you had to make it, homemade cake or pie. So then you had your four food groups. You had your meat, you had your vegetable, you had your side dish, and your dessert. And then somewhere around 1972, my Aunt Asley discovered the congealed salad. And you know how, you know, it's one of them items like the bundt cake. Everybody just jumped on the bandwagon, but they didn't know where to put that in the four food groups. So they finally just said, okay, we got five now. So everybody brought a congealed salad. Now, you had to take a little bit of everything there, right? Because you didn't want to hurt anybody's feelings, because chances are you're going to be staying at their house next time you come over to visit. You don't want to offend anybody's cooking, so you take a little bit of everything. That makes for a paper plate full of food, folks. The only good thing about it is all the congealed salads were green, so just anybody is a little dib of that, you know. I mean, nobody ate it anyway, you know. Now, my ex-wife's family, I'm not going to call any names because I used to be a songwriter in Nashville. I was a professional songwriter in Nashville, so I have more than one ex-wife. So I'm not going to call any names here. But my ex-wife's family, now cooking to them was a different thing. Cooking in my family meant you grew things and you prepared things, you know, and you made things and you enjoyed things, right? They took cooking literally. They would go to the store and buy something, put it in a pot, turn the stove on, and come back next week and say, do you think that's done yet? My mother-in-law, if we were going to have ham for lunch on Sunday, she'd go to the store and buy one of them 5-pound canned hams, you know, that thing where you put the, you screw that thing around the top and then you, and it finally comes out on the plate. Now you can take a knife and scrape that jelly stuff off of there and slice that and make a ham sandwich right now, because if you read that lid, it says Armor pre-cooked ham. My mother-in-law would take one of them hams and put it in a pressure cooker. and pour about a quart of water in there on that and lock a lid down on her sometime about Saturday afternoon. And she'd take the lid off of it right before lunch on Sunday. And when she would open the lid of that, she'd look in there, and it just was like these white strings laying in this pool of stuff, you know? But like the Thanksgiving turkey, she would buy like a 20-pound frozen turkey and put it in the sink and turn the tap water on it and leave it until you could take your finger and completely submerge your finger to the third knuckle in that boy. It was thawed. And then she would get one of those aluminum, you know, those disposable aluminum turkey pans, and she would put that turkey in there and wrap it up in heavy-duty aluminum wrap, and she would turn the oven on about 2,000 degrees and slide that turkey in there on Labor Day. And when she finally tore into that wrap, it looked like if you went to the Smithsonian and they had an exhibit of a pterodactyl skeleton laying in the La Brea tar pits. See, they had, cooking to them meant, by golly, we're going to cook this, you know. And a picnic to them meant, well, let's run down to the lake and we'll stop at the convenience store on the way and pick something up, you know. So, there's all kinds of picnics. I'm just a July watermelon who on a Sunday morning paper lost my life. I was floating in a tub of ice with some Diet Coke and a peach knee-high. Then your daddy showed up with a butcher knife. I'm a big old batch of Jones potato salad in her mama's bowl with saran wrap on my head. You better sit me in the shade, 'cause I'm made with mayonnaise. Unless you wanna wake up Monday morning dead. A little family picnic in a little patch of shade with KFC fried chicken that your grandma says she made. There's a little something extra in Uncle Elmer's lemonade. Sunday with the family. Ain't life great? I'm the hot dog on the grill, so plump and juicy. Go on and take a big bite out of me. I'm full of fats and dyes. Don't you wish you had some fries? Why not just insert me in an artery? I'm the meatloaf made with mostly soda crackers. I'm the Jell-O salad made with God knows what. The cake icing's mostly lard. We got chips by the cubic yard with salt enough to cause your blood to clot. A little family picnic in a little patch of shade with KFC fried chicken that your grandma swears she made. There's a little something extra in Uncle Elmer's lemonade. Sunday with the family, ain't life great? I'm the yellow jacket nest under the blanket. I'm the million fire ants craving sweet iced tea. I'm the hailstorm on the lake. I'm that den of angry snakes and the poison ivy patch up to your knee. A little family picnic in a little patch of shade with KFC fried chicken that your grandma says she made. There's a little something extra in Uncle Elmer's lemonade. Sunday with the family, ain't life great?